music and some of the guests, I need to sneak in with their alcohol. Really misbehaving after using the police most of the times the guests were allowed to walk around, big space around, walk into the field. With a big football field, they could walk around, take walks, and they are supposed to be in their rooms. Like, we are urging every Kenyan, stay at home, keep your distance from each other, the social space to tenet. But mostly, these people were all the time anxious, and they would want to ask questions, and they would want to come back together to because of anxiety.
This center
has been vacated, and before we had it back to the Council of Government, allow for the good use of the public again. We want to make sure that it is well disinfected. We will not have any more risks to any other persons who will come here, if at all. So we need to do a lot of disinfection. We are going to use the fumigation method of disinfection, that is using fumigants to ensure that we make the place safe. As a public health officer, I would say that we've been very much at the front line of fighting this disease right from the airport. When you reach the airport, you get the port health officers. The first time these people were coming into the, because these were reported cases, our public health officers were exposed, and that time nobody knew about protective gear. Eventually, we had the warnings from the WHO and other officials having the gun, the temperature guns. We're already doing the temperature guns at the airport. When we go to the villages, we have been doing a lot of health education, getting public awareness. When it comes to the time we've got the first case, the public health officers have been on the front line to go and test contact tracing. So as you can well see, even at the quarantine centers here, we've been meeting and talking to these fellows. We are the people who have been handling them, answering their questions. Before a case is confirmed, everybody looks normal. So we are the first people normally to deal with any even a hotspot, any risks.
And is there any special service that you receive?
Well, I would say that so far so good. Our good government has been supporting us in all ways that we want, although it might take that we need more help in terms of protective gears. In terms of the public health should be compensated. Also, if you find other cadres like doctors and nurses, that everybody's talking about them, they're forgetting that we are doing a lot of work here, fumigating around here, disinfecting here, going to homes to make sure that we identify cases. The public health act is very clear about even disposal of dead bodies. Public health officers should be there to ensure that that body is well disposed. Those ones should not be overlooked. That one should be well cleared on the counties. I think the Minister of Health has been giving guidelines to all the counties and anybody who is supposed to be concerned for that matter.
Do you?